Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to explain further steps of beam design. We have already calculated how to calculate area of steel in the beam. Now we have to calculate further steps in while designing a beam. The further step include design shear force. Then we have to calculate our beam check. Then we have to calculate deflection of our beam. So checking our beam, how much is going to deflect. Okay, the next step is design shear force. Okay, formula for this is going to be VED1 is equal to shear force divided by 0.9 BW multiplied by D. Okay, so here VED, this is a small lowercase VED. So this VED represent side of the beam, okay, where our beam is rested. For example, so this is our beam. This is our beam support, and then this is our beam. So the V would represent this area, VED, so one side, okay. Shear force we already calculated from our previous calculation, which is 88.125 multiplied by 10 to power 3 divided by 0.9 multiplied by B. Width is 200 millimeters and the depth is 359. The answer we will get 1.36 Newton per millimeter square. Okay, now we have to calculate area of steel in shear. Okay, area of steel in shear. The formula for that is going to be ASW divided by S equals to 0.0009 VED1, or you can also write 2, because if your beam is resting on the same support, then both side will be VED, both side will be equal. I mean VED1 equal to VED2, so I am writing VED1. I can also write VED2, but it's the same thing. Multiply by B, 0.009 multiplied by VED we have just calculated is 1.36 multiplied by width is 200. Okay, so we will get 0.25 millimeter square per millimeter. So this is what we have calculated. This is we have calculated with this formula, but there is standard formula given. We have FC. Yes, FC, a concrete strength is 30 Newton. So if you have a concrete strength 30 Newton, then it means we have to use a particular formula to fulfill this requirement. This formula comes out from Eurocode. The formula comes out from table number C5. Okay, because we have 30 kilonewton FCK, so the formula would be 0.00000888 multiply by B. Okay, so it'll be 0.008, width is 200. So we will get 0.176 millimeter square per millimeter. Okay, so the idea is we have calculated area of steel in shear, which is using this formula. But then we have a given standard formula from the table. We have to compare what we have calculated, what we have given with FCK value 30. So we have calculated and we have got 0.176. Okay, now we have to check our beam, like in our beam, how much spacing we are going to provide in our beam. Formula for maximum link spacing is going to be 0.75D. This is a standard formula we have to use. We have to remain within that formula. Okay, so if we use that, depth is 359, we will get 269.25 millimeter. So this is 269.25 millimeter is a link spacing. So let's say this is our main bar and these are our links, and this spacing has to be 269.25 according to our formula. Okay. So it will be, because we have to round this number up or down. So I am going to round it down to 250 millimeter. So round down. Okay. Now, that's what I have said. The statement which I should write for your better understanding, use 250 millimeter links spacing with area of steel not less than 0.176. Okay. So once we have that, which bar, which diameter we are going to use? We are going to use H8 links bar diameter, for example, at 250 millimeter spacing. Okay. So the idea is we have to use 8 diameter. This is what we have picked up. You can have different diameter of link spacing. Links. I have picked 8 millimeter diameter for links at 250 millimeter apart. Okay, now we have to check our beam in deflection. Okay, the next step and the final step of our beam design is we have to check our beam in deflection. To calculate or to check whether our beam is going to deflect, we have to use this formula. Actual effective span divided by effective depth. Okay, so span is 5 meter, as you can see, in 5000 millimeters divided by 359. This is our effective depth, and the value we have got 13.93. Now we have to calculate percentage of our steel. Percentage of steel reinforcement which is required, for example. The formula for this is rho is equal to area of steel divided by B multiplied by depth multiplied by 100. Okay, so it will be, this is the area of steel which we have used previously, divided by 200 multiplied by 359 multiplied by 100. So the percentage of area we will get is 1.4. Okay, so we have got 1.4. If we go to table number C7, percentage of main reinforcement area, rho is going to be 0.1.4%. If we have 1.4%, then basic span over effective depth ratio will be 14.6. So we will use 14.6 from the table, from the Euro code. Okay. Now we have to do further calculation. So the further calculation includes modification factor. We have to calculate, we have to use modification factor. Modification factor is area of steel which is provided. So I will just write provided, area of steel which is required. Okay, so the area of steel provided from the table is 1005, which we picked up, and this is what we have calculated with the formula. Now the answer is 1.21, which is less than 1.5. So this area, I mean this modification factor, should not increase 1.5. So 1.5 is the standard, so we are less than 1.5, so we are okay. Once you have calculated your modification factor, we have to calculate permitted span divided by depth ratio, okay, equals to basic span divided by depth ratio. multiply by modification factor. So this is quite a lengthy formula which I am going to use. Permitted span over depth ratio is a one thing equals to basic span over depth ratio multiplied by modification factor. So the actual thing is going to be 14.6, which we have picked up from our table from Eurocode, multiplied by 1.21. So we will get 17.67. Now the final thing, we have 17.67 greater than 13.93. Okay, so it means our permitted value is 17.67, which is greater than our actual effective span over effective depth ratio is 13.93. Okay, the next step is modification factor. Modification factor is area of steel provided divided by area of steel required. Area of steel provided, I mean, which we have got it from our table, provided in the table, divided by area of steel which we have calculated is required. We were required this much and we got it from the table 1005. Okay, once we have this, then we have to calculate permitted span over depth ratio equals to basic span divided by depth ratio multiplied by modification factor. Permitted span over depth ratio is equal to basic span over depth ratio multiplied by modification factor. The values we are going to use is 14.6 from the table from Eurocode, multiplied by modification factor, which is 1.21. We have calculated early on, as you can see. The final value we will get 17.67. Okay, 17.67 is greater than 13.93. 13.93 is actual effective span over effective depth ratio we have calculated early on. But the one which we have calculated while using modification factor, we have got 17.67. So this is greater than what we have actually calculated. So it means our beam is okay in deflection. That's it for today. Thank you for watching my video. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel.